And now we're gonna go play here on the floor. And what we have here is some toys, homemade toys. Like this, for example, is a milk can with little rocks in it to make it noise proof. So the puppy is not afraid when it hears noise. It's hungry again. And then here I have a little Bluetooth speaker. And with the Bluetooth speaker, I want to play fireworks. So I have to find my fireworks. But if you notice, the camera is shaking because the puppy is eating the cord of the selfie stick. That's uncool. But for this video now, I want to find the music. Here. Fireworks. So I made this myself. I just have to see that I pair to the right thing. Oh, there we go. So we turn the volume down a little bit. And then we have to set this here to repeat. Isn't there a repeat button? Here. How do you repeat those songs? I don't know. So I leave this on here. We have this noise here. Out, out. You're eating my stick. Out, 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 out. There you go. So you're eating my stick. Here, what about this one? So that's very good that the puppy is going so close. And it's not afraid of fireworks right now. But this fireworks now is quiet. It's not very loud. We can change the volume a little bit. And he's just carrying around my fireworks Bluetooth speaker. So what we have to be careful is that he doesn't chew on it. You are not chewing on my fireworks, no. And he can play with it. Let me turn this up a little more, a little louder. And so changing the volume, he's hiding from me. So he's getting used to his, he thought he can have this in his playhouse. So that means he really likes fireworks. But he wants to eat it. Hey, don't eat my fireworks. So supervision is very much important in this case, because you don't want him to swallow any of the parts of the speaker. Now, this is a good JBL speaker. This can take a little bit of a hit of a puppy at least. But we are lucky now that he likes it so much. If he wouldn't like it, here, I turn it up a little. If he wouldn't like it, then we would have to play it a little more quiet. And the thing here is that he took it into his own kennel, in his own crate, on his own. You don't like it? See, this may be a little too loud then. Not so, as long as he goes to it, and if he wants to keep it and walk around with it, that's fine. And we have to do this a couple of times so that he gets used to this noise. And chances are, when we have a firework by the end of the year, oh, here I have to repeat it. If chances are that, here I have to really. There we go. Chances are that at the end of the year, when there is a fireworks, or 4th of July, or whenever you have a fireworks, that the puppy can handle that situation. That he can handle this very good. But the point is now that he likes to play with it, that he is around it. So if you have a puppy that is afraid of this, you would keep it away a little further. But as I said, as long as he plays with it, if he takes off with it, right, just turn it up. make it a little louder. And where do you get the sounds from? So I recorded this myself. Last firework, before I had the dog, I just recorded the firework. And now I can replay this a lot. So he can hear people screaming there in the background, and the noise. And you can see you don't have it. He looks at it funny. And so we can now, over time, take a bigger speaker, a larger one, play it louder. What is it? What is it? I only have that for me. Yeah, that's a good boy. What a good boy. Fireworks is not good. You're not chewing on my fireworks. No chewing on my fireworks. No chewing on my fireworks. You're not chewing on my fireworks. That's a good boy. What about this rattle thing, huh? What about this? This is not good. Don't eat my fireworks. You have to see, there's no damage so far. I have one corner here. Ow! My finger! I have one corner here that I did with a screwdriver. So he is already learning to be a little bit careful with my stuff. And not chew a piece off. But if I would leave the dog alone with it... Yeah, I have to start over with my file. Oh, we lost the pairing. What happened? Oh. So what happened is he bit on the on-off button. And that means this thing turned off. I think that's what happened. There we go. We are back online. Yeah, he did bite the on-off button. That's a little tricky. Oh, you like that one, huh? Oh. Don't bite the on-off button, then it turns off. That sounds different, does it? Does that sound different? You good boy. You good boy. So right now you can hear that my rattle here, this one, is louder than the fireworks. And at the end, we want to have this volume, this loud, that we play the fireworks that loud. Yeah, I'm gonna turn this off more on. So I'm not shaking with my camera. It's the dog eating my tripod. Ouch! Not eating my tripod. No tripod eaten. Here, what about this one? You can eat my speaker. Here. This one. Ow, ow, ow! So is he coming back to it? And playing with it is perfect. Look at this, how loud it is now. And he's just wanting to keep it. He just wants to keep it. Good boy. Good boy, taking off with my fireworks. Huh? You taking off with my fireworks? So he has a very good experience with it. You can also add food to this. So if the puppy behaves like this, that he doesn't care about it. Let's see if I have here. Do kibbles, oh, he can hear me by kibbles. Come on. Come here, come. Come on, where are you? Come here. Look here, there's one. I just put the kibble on it. Here, there it is, look. Here, there. Oh, you get it? Here, there. Put the kibble on the noise. At the height of the fireworks. Look at that. Very good, good boy. So now the scary noises, food, the puppy is relaxed. It's like a good puppy. Yeah, it's a good puppy. Really good boy. That's some good boy. See, that turned off on its own. Because sometimes it does. Because my file ended. I should have a longer file. Yeah, I'm gonna play this again. I should have a longer file for this, but I don't. Ah. Ow, 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 ow. So if I would have a longer file, it would be easier for me. Let's see here, what do we have here? Oh, look. There's another rattle. And not that you think that we do this so loud always with the poor puppy ears. So this is a short training session where we are very loud. We also have very quiet sessions. You know? We do have very quiet training sessions. But this one is a loud one. And now the little booger is a little hungry again. He's going for a lot more food. Huh? You gonna eat some more kibbles? You're always so hungry. Huh? Yeah, this is like regular kibbles. Puppy kibbles. And we get water. We have to refill his water. But all right, so that is it for the first training here for this one.